Hello everyone, welcome to another Godot Firebase tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to implement Firebase Realtime Database in your Godot game. Realtime Database is useful if you want the game to get notified when there is something updated on your cloud. This is not possible to do with some other services, as they won't get notified when there is something changed on the cloud. Before starting, you should have already created the Firebase project, installed the Godot Firebase plugin, and have the basic authentication implemented. If not, please take a look at my previous tutorial. The first half of it will show you how to do so. By the way, I have uploaded this project to GitHub. Link is in the description. Alright, let's get started. The first thing you want to do is go to the Firebase console. On the left panel, expand Build and click on Realtime Database. Create the database. Choose your desired database collection. For the security rules, select Test Mode. We'll get back to it later. Now you have your Realtime Database created. Click on this button to copy the database URL and paste it to your .env file. Oh, by the way, if you didn't include the HTTP SSC client folder when installing the plugin, you need to add that to your add-ons folder as we need it for the real-time database implementation. Next, let's get back to the Godot editor. Here, I have some UI elements ready to demonstrate how the real-time database works. In this example, I want to show a list of the users and their status. In the script, we want to get the database reference first. Firebase.database.getDatabaseReference. The first argument will be the path you want to look at. In my case, play status. The second argument will be the filter, which we are not going to use in this example. So just leave it empty for now. Then, in the ready function, connect the new data update signal to a function called newDataUpdated. Do the same thing for patch data update signal. The new data update signal will emit when the app is connected to the database or when there's new data added to it. And the patch data update signal will emit when something is changed on the user status path after we've connected to it. We can then print to see the format of the returned data. Of course, it's not printing anything as the database is currently empty. Let's add some data to it manually on the Firebase console. As you can see, it gets notified when we add new entry to the database. I'm not going into too much detail on how to parse it. It's useful if you want to make minor adjustments in your game based on the updates, so you don't have to refresh everything when there's just a single change. I'll include the code where I do the parsing in the sample project. But for simplicity's sake, in this tutorial, we'll use the getData function to get all data. Again, I'm not going to explain the details on this part of the code. It's basically looping through the dictionary and printing them out on the label. Let's try it out. As you can see, it's listing out all the players. If we update it on the console, the app will get notified and update as well. Now let's implement the update button here. When it's pressed, we want to call dbRefUpdate with the player ID as the key and the text in the line edits as the data. Alright, let's try it out. I'll use Bob as a name and Angry as a status. Press Update. You can see that it's updated in the list here. It's also updated on the console. Let's try using two clients. Here, I have them logged into two different accounts. When I update the status on the first client, the second one is updated as well. Remember the security rules? In my case, I want to allow everyone who logged in to read all players' data from the player status path. But only the player with the matching UID can write to a specific entry. That's all for this tutorial. If you find it helpful, don't forget to leave a like on the video. And please consider subscribing for more game dev tutorial and contents. I'm Boon, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.